So, gentlemen, we are live.
Shall I start?
Yeah, please go ahead.
Oh, thank you. Good evening, everyone, and warm welcome from Omdal Group of Institutions to today's webinar. It is a great pleasure to see many of you who have registered as participants. I am Dr. Shukanna, the moderator for this webinar. Omdal Group of Institutions is one of the leading colleges under Maulana Abul Kalam Azad University of Technology, offering BTech courses in mechanical engineering, computer science engineering, civil engineering, and electrical engineering and B.Arch courses. Today, the electrical engineering department of Omdal Group of Institutions is presenting the webinar on challenges and opportunities for electrical engineers during and in post-pandemic situation. As you all know, the COVID pandemic is impacting every sphere of life globally, especially on businesses and education, resulting in economic crisis, which in turn will cause career threats. Today, we are privileged to have amongst us Mr. Shoibal Kumar Kunju, Associate Partner in IBM India, Dr. Arup Sinha, Professor of Electrical Engineering Department, and Professor Shapun Kumar Mojumdar, Teacher in Charge of Electrical Engineering Department, who will enlighten us on how we can deal with these issues in the coming days. Now, for the audience, if you have any question, please write in the chat box, which shall be answered after the presentation. I would request the participants to mute their audio and video while the presentation is on. Moving on, I will introduce you to our chief guest for the day, Mr. Shoibal Kumar Kunju. He is an associate partner in IBM India, working in a leadership position of energy and utility department. He has more than 26 years of experience in consulting for electricity utility industry in India and abroad. Prior to IBM, he has worked with TCS and Capgemini India in similar fields. He has graduated in engineering from National Institute of Technology, Kurukshetra, in 1993. Sir, over to you.
Thank you, sir, Suparna, to introduce me to the audience. Okay,
thank you, sir.
It's a nice introduction. Okay, thank you for that, and thank you the respective audiences and the panelists who are joining me in this today's session. Okay, so I would not like to basically take more time in introducing myself. Like what you have said, I have been working with a lot of companies and I have focused in energy utilities field for over 20 years out of my total career of 26 years plus. And that too in multiple organizations like TCS, IBM, Capgemini. And currently I'm focusing on the energy utilities business development for IBM in India and South Asia. So that's my current role. So today we are definitely in a very difficult situations, right? So last year what we see and starting this year, we started basically getting news from China and all. We were not that scared kind of thing, right? And gradually the more we basically moved into to 2020 and all, I mean, the grief situations, it basically percolated across world, right? Because we are a global community today, right? So we have seen the other pandemic situations in past like MARS, SARS and all, but definitely today it's a global village. People are really connected and all. And that's the impact. The globalization impact has basically created a havoc to the humanity, right? Across most of the countries in the world. So what we see that okay, as the world gears up to combat the current pandemic situation, countries are basically putting stringent lockdown measures. Business are basically trying to see whether they are able to continue or not. So, in fact, the businesses are basically working along with the basically respective governments to figure it out what kind of basically aids they are going to go get, how they are going to basically cope up with the current situations, what's the basically new normal. So obviously what we were basically there 3 months before, so there the situations are going to change. So what today is the situations, it's going to be the new normal, right? So we have to basically re-pivot our approach towards basically health, education, and other spheres of the life, whatever we are doing today. So definitely the way of basically continuing our life is going to change, right? So what we have seen from the IBM side, right? So first we have to basically, so when we talk about, first we have to basically take care of our own health, okay? So organizations are trying to revive first, then they are thinking of basically getting into the normalized situations. The governments are basically giving a lot of SOPs. There are lockdown situations that they are still there, but it's opening up in a new way, right? With new SOPs and all. Then we have to basically reinvent. That's the approach. Now, how do we reinvent, right? What are the sectors? Various sectors basically have been analyzed by, let's say, from our organization perspective. The government has also analyzed various sectors and all and trying to basically get measures. So we see that there are high resilience sectors, medium resilience sectors, low resilience sectors, right? So if I talk about certain industries like tourism, hospitality, retail, manufacturing, definitely they're the worst hit, right? Including the automotive and all. Now, if I see the today's discussions on the energy and utility sector and all, so this sector, it's a essential services, providing the essential services to the industry, be it commercial, be it domestic, or be it industrial, right? Now, obviously, due to the, lockdown situation for last 2 to 3 months, what we have seen, there is a lot of reduction in industrial requirement, right? So, but having said that, the way of approach towards work, office work and all, it has changed. A lot of cases, government organizations are still basically operating from office with a reduced manpower. But however, a lot of industries like IT, very specific, and other also utilities also and service sectors and all, they are trying to see, can we basically operate some of our workforce mainly from basically home, at least for an extended period of 3 to 6 months. You have been hearing this information from Google and other IT organizations. They are, let's say, for TCS and all, they are basically repivoting their way of basically working in IT industries and all, right? So definitely there will be a basically shift in industry. Power utilities, if I see that, there is a shift in demand. So the industry may not be working at this point of time. Gradually, it's going to open up, okay? So there has been a basically what you see from Indian context, there has been a reduction of around 30% of power need, right? Overall power need. So there has been a basically loss of revenue from the DISCOM side. And in terms of the basically payment and other things, DISCOMs are basically having challenges and all. But however, being essential service, they have to keep the lights on, right? That's a major need, right? Whether it's in office or in residence. So the thing is that there will be a basically shift of power usage, right? So what we see that, let's say till 2019, the usage of power, that the peak period. So it was happening in, if I take care of the basically Indian context, it was happening sometime in, post office hours kind of thing, right? The peak demand kind of thing. So it was around 7:30 kind of thing in the evening. Now, if I see that, there has been a change in the basically timing. So the peak demand change. So it has, instead of evening, it is basically showing in the morning, right? When most of the people, whoever is basically trying to basically work from home or the industry also is basically opening up, it's happening in maybe 10:30 around 11 o'clock in the morning, right? So there has been some changes, right? So similarly, there will be a lot of changes are going to happen, right? In terms of the, there is a challenge in terms of the companies surviving, okay, how they are going to survive. There is a cost crunch, okay. They are trying to basically, preserve their whatever, basically, instead of splurging in basically unnecessary projects and all, they are trying to see what is essential, right? They are trying to conserve the cash. So whoever is having the cash, they are the king today. Even the Warren Buffett and all, if you really see that Warren Buffett is also basically not that much investing in various industries and all, right? So obviously from the industry standpoint, we see there will be basically a lot of dynamism in terms of changing the basically way they were used to work and going to the basically new way of working, okay? So in terms of the generation and all, if I see from the Indian sector, the generation, transmission and distribution, so there has been a reduction in the basically in the power demand, overall power demand, right? So generation sector is definitely is going to get impacted, right? And also the industry will try to basically look for more green energy. They had already started that initiative. However, they will also be looking for basically cheap power, right? So they will try to see that can we completely, or most of the cases, can we depend on renewable energy, low cost power, okay, green energy. That's a kind of target. So if I see the coal-based power plants and all, there will be a lot of reduction from that. However, there will be basically demand definitely is going to basically increase on the residential side. A lot of high-rise buildings are basically putting up PVs as well as various solar units and all. So definitely a lot of demand will be basically catered from those renewable generation units and all, right? And in terms of the basically the finances and all, currently Indian distribution sector or Indian IPPs, okay, they have been basically struggling for their cash, right? And it's a basically a challenge which it's been continued over years and all. Now Indian government has basically given certain directions, okay, certain funding and all. So we have to see that how those funding gets channelized properly. DISCOMs, state electricity distribution companies who are reeling under major cash challenges and all for operations and all, because the utility has to run. Okay, you cannot stop, right? Maybe the dynamisms are going to change. Maybe the way of operations are going to change, but they have to run. We have to keep our lights on. So they are having a major challenge today. So they have to think, how can they basically give a lean and thin operations, right? They have to optimize their operations. They have to make their customer services much better, right? They have to reach the customer in a much better way. There are a lot of digitalizations are also happening, okay? So manual bills and all these things, anyway, it started to reduce. So we see this trend is going to continue. So that's it from my end. I tried to basically create a synopsis, whatever I felt. If there is any questions, I can take up now or probably at the end of the discussion and all, when in a common forum.
Thank you, sir. Next, we have Professor Dr. Arup Sinha. Professor Sinha is an electrical engineer with PhD in power systems, having more than 26 years of diverse experience in research, consulting, teaching, and industry operations in core utility industry, large engineering and business consulting firm, and reputed engineering educational institutes or universities in India and abroad. Sir, please enlighten us with your talk.
Thank you, madam. Thank you, Mr. Saival, for the details of thing. So, good afternoon to all participants and good afternoon all panelists. So, let's this thing I'm going to segregate into two parts as per my career, as mentioned by madam. So, I worked in the industry. I work associated with the educational institute. So, I know that across the globe, I worked across the globe during my industry experience. So I know that what is the things are happening now, what are the things was there, and what has to be done after this post scenario. So that part we'll discuss, and being that education part, I will also say that what are the opportunity for that current electrical engineering graduate, those are now studying, and also those are the people are thinking to study in the electrical engineering phase. So that I will say that post COVID scenario, what are the opportunity will come, and how will that meet our that things. So let's look into this COVID-19. It's a basically now we are almost 3-4 months past. Now situation is used to be. I think I not said that situation, that problem has gone. Problem is still there, and problem is day to day increasing. But gradually we are used to with this problem. Initially you thought about in the time of month of March. So that time how much threat was there? Only we are thinking to survival our life. But now today we are thinking to both. We are thinking jivan and jivika. Jaan bhi hai, jahan bhi hai. So all these things slogan is coming now. It means that we have to survive our life also, as well as also we find out the way to lead a life. Means that you have to earning the things made to run your day to day life. So that's why the thing now coming into this theme, you could look into that across the globe. As I mentioned earlier in different forum, engineers are not a local. It is not a engineer for it is a West Bengal engineer, or it is a India engineer, or it is a kind of things. Always engineers for the global. They do not have as such any boundary. See that those are people passing engineering here in West Bengal. They are doing their job in Germany. They are doing job in Australia. And even the electrical engineer passing out any college from West Bengal or any college from here. So they are working across the globe. But if you look into the scenario today, even starting from US, that's the biggest I can say that job opportunity creator. And then Europe. So we know that those who are the developed country, they always have a fixed budget to run their project, both engineering project and especially non-engineering project. You know that in the current date, if you look into the employment perspective, 80% job are the non-engineering job and 20% job are engineering job. Whenever I say that engineering and non-engineering job, engineering means that what are the subject you are studying during your graduation, whether it is electrical engineering, mechanical engineering, electronics engineering, you are doing this job on the subject, then we are say that you are in the core engineering part. And if non-engineering, those who are the job, especially the IT job, customer care service job, sales marketing job, these jobs are under the non-engineering job. If you look into the market is basically today in the maximum non-engineering job. I can say 80%, even 90% job. Everybody knows that most of the employment happened on the IT sector, and especially those who are the big player there, like IBM, like TCS, like Accenture, like Wipro, they used to hire the maximum people, engineering graduate from that government and non-government college. But see, these people are not hiring for the work for Wipro. See that this non-engineering space, they hired this consultant and this engineer for the job across the globe. They used to get the job from that, mostly from the developed country. If I specifically told those who are the people, IT major player are there, they are 40 to 50% business comes from US, and then remaining 30% business comes from Europe, and remaining 20% business comes from Asian country, Australia, South Africa, these are country. So what does it mean? It means that mostly job, whatever the things is giving by this IT player, our job with the project is from that developed country. So as you know today, understand that what are the situation today in that US and Europe, that is very pathetic. And I know that there will be the consequences there. So as such, from the negative point of view, yes, there are a lot of challenges that we need to face in the due course of time, okay? And we'll see that how we can mitigate the thing. And then again, that engineering people have to come in picture, alternative way, alternative geography, how that we can look into it. But that's the big challenge today. Everybody has to look into it. And also something that there are nothing to do, have to watch on this part also. So these are the things, few challenges are there. But the biggest opportunity is also coming. How the opportunity is coming? As you know, today, mostly company is coming with this that hardly that 20% job could be done from that customer premises. Remaining 70-80% job they are expecting people will do from their home. It means that a lot of thing has to be developed in terms of the infrastructure point of view. Lot of the things to be done from the network point of view. Lot of the things to be done from that your communication point of view. And this is the one part. So there is an opportunity. And then you have a plenty of time because see that whenever you travel in office, so actually your I used to calculate that around 3 hours and 4 hours we spent during the traveling. So I think in the other way, it's an opportunity. So I am saving 3 to 4 hours a day. And if I proactively and constructively utilize those days with hours in my work, I think my productivity will be increased. So this is the one part. Second part, since that those who are the big player, big employer, they are also thinking that how we can run our business, their business. So how can they run the business? So they are also trying to develop some innovative way. So that I'm just giving you an example. By the TCS, they are thinking by 2025, they are 75% people will work from home, remaining 25% will people work only at their offices. Similarly, that other player also will follow the same path. It means that those are the people, big player, they are developing the innovative way to increase that or to get the productivity of their employee. Those are working from home. And of course, due to earlier that working from home concept was different, the COVID-19, because that time people is taking the very relaxation because that time that kind of monitoring was not there. And whenever the person was working from home, except few organization, rest of the organization was not taking very seriously. If somebody working from home, they are taking it sometime, okay, it's fine. But now that things is only way to working from home, and then the measuring point they mentioned that they are tracking their output, and now that all the employee and every person has to be work proactively, has to be relevant to the organization, and also end of the day have to show that the value addition to the industry. So these are the few things. Due course of time, people have to take care to survival thing. And now coming to the electrical engineering perspective. So in specifically from the electrical, since myself is an electrical engineer and I work as an electrical engineer in many years. So basically, if you look into the electrical engineer, it's a field job. It's not a home job. If you look into whenever you're working in any industry, whether it is a power generation industry, power transmission industry, power distribution industry, the electrical person has to be at site, okay? And whether it is a plant, even engineer are not required only that in the power generation part. They are is a universal engineer. They are required in the cement industry. They are required in the textile industry. They are required in the steel industry. Everywhere they are required because today's life, without electricity, nothing can run. So even the construction company, that electrical engineers are required to run their all the machinery. So whenever there is any machinery, electrical engineers are required. But so that point of view, electrical engineer is a field job. But in the current scope, since we are saying that the situation is coming, that we need to work from home. Now there are a job in electrical engineering perspective. So that some job yes, definitely need that engineer's presence at site. Specifically those few area that field supervision, field action is required. But many job can be done from that home also. First thing that operation part, all the operation of the power system. So power system operation today is the date of communication. So whatever the things they has to manage there inside their plant, they can manage remotely sitting anywhere because of that internet facility. So still there is a job, electrical engineer job, so sitting at home. Second part is that it is the area, artificial intelligence, although it is a subject of computer science, but application part of AI, there is a lot of electrical engineering is there. So electrical engineer can look into the artificial intelligence, application of artificial intelligence on the smart grid, and those who are the current latest technology in the electricity distribution network. So they can develop that artificial technology, that intelligence technology for that power system. And of course, with the help of computer science, but electrical engineering possibly their big role to play. Actually, they are the person who understand that part. Only that computer science engineer can support them. Then other main areas, they are like design. Design is also one of the big area of electrical. So that area, it is a remote job. So people can work from home. So one point I'm trying to say, the out of 100% job, still there will be 20-25% job to be done in the field. There's 75% job we can do in the remotely, but only we have to choose our place and sensitively need to select the area where we can be able to give that output. Okay. And now student perspective, I will say they have to choose the subject. What are the optional subject now from that third year onwards, fourth year onwards? Means that they are sixth semester, seventh semester, eighth semester. They have to look into what are the latest technology. Even they are electrical engineering, but they have to see that what are the technology which will help them to bring the things, automation process. Although that is not directly in the electrical engineering subject, but being a electrical, they are supposed to know that subject so that they can apply. And whenever there is a job opportunity, they can apply for that job and they can build their career and so their place. So in that perspective, I can say, of course, there is a threat to the mankind, not only that job, in today's day, it is a threat to the mankind, it is a survival of mankind today. But as I told, the person, whenever you survive, you have to live the life also. And to the live the life, you have to resources also live the life. So everywhere that not only engineers also, I think that those who are the everybody, it is applicable to everyone to look up the opportunity for his own survival and also that survival of the society. So thank you. That's all from my side.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for the information. Next, we have Professor Shapun Kumar Majumdar. Professor Majumdar did AME from the Institution of Engineers, Kolkata. M.Tech from RCCII, Kolkata. He did DOEC A-level from National Institute of Electronics and Information Technology, New Delhi. He is also a chartered engineer. He has more than 9 years of teaching experience and 20 years technical experience in Indian Air Force. He is presently the teacher in charge of Electrical Engineering Department of Omdal Group of Institutions. Sir, please share your thoughts on this occasion. Shapun, sir, please.
Sir, you are not audible.
Hello, is it audible?
It's okay.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am, for nice introduction. Let me talk about a little bit of my Air Force career because there is a similarity with that new situation, that is new normal situation that we are dealing with. That is what we used to do in Indian Air Force because I was in the missile complex with that name, surface-to-air missile, SHAM-3, Pichora missile. So what was our target? That if that enemy target comes, then we are required to destroy it. But you know that enemy target comes from far away, we can't see it. So what we had actually used to do, we used to switch on radar, and we used to wait for that if enemy target comes to our scope. Okay, but practically with our naked eyes, we could not see anything. Similarly, if we talk about COVID-19, that virus, that we call it invisible enemy that are coming to mankind and they are attacking us. So here, that is the thing, but that you know that this COVID situation, this current and post-COVID situation, I'm sure that that only engineers and doctors can help it out. You all know that when we were in child, that everybody used to speak that the pillars of the society are doctors and engineers. And you know that if I talk about the doctors, engineers, And you know, in many cases, the doctors are dependent on the engineering marvels that the engineers they create for the doctors. Because without engineering marvels, doctors are also helpless in many cases. So doctors or engineers should go hand in hand so that they can perfectly deal with the new situation that has come across to our life. So what I mean to say that new situation that we are going through and will go through, people are afraid of. But I think that this new situation actually will boost that technological applications. Because now you see that we all are already in the house and we are all waiting for the scientists that if they can invent a vaccine, then we'll be free as we are before. So the new situation, what I feel that the post-COVID situation or current situation, that more and more technological applications will run in play. And I am sure that only engineers and doctors together can give a normal society as before to a good extent, because they are continuously trying for inventing medicines. And I'm sure that technologists are also helping to give many instruments so that they can continue the research and they can invent medicines. So what I mean to say that now this world are in a state of sadness and a lot of there is financial losses across the globe. But I think that this new situation, this new normal situation, that actually has brought certain optimism to the engineers that the opportunity has come for them to play in a new way, to give a new thought to the society, and so that we can defeat actually coronavirus. As actually earlier panelists, they have correctly said, and they have actually exposed many things. But here I'll add a few things to that. What I mean to say that what new fields are coming up for the electrical engineers. New fields, for example, as already Arup sir told something about it, that what is all about electrical engineers? If I talk about particularly, if I concentrate on the electrical engineering field, because that is our discussion part here, that is the central theme of our discussion, that we actually deal with this power generation and distribution mainly. So what actually is required here, what this new situation has given an opportunity to the electrical current and future electrical engineers, that if you look into these present power sectors, mainly power generators and distribution system, also in the grid system, we see that there were actually semi-automatic systems. Okay, because that situation did not demand, and naturally that would cost more. If we make that exclusive automation for every field. But this, as if you come across these present power plants and power sectors, they are basically, I can categorize as that they are semi-automatic system or semi-complex system. Now time has come, because this is the time we need that there should be physical distancing and there should be minimum human manpower should work on the physical site. So what actually that opportunities are coming to the electrical engineers, that semi-automatic power sector need to be converted into a exhaustive and exclusive or rather say fully automatic power sectors. So that needs a new challenge to the electrical engineers, and that this challenge has actually and opened up the opportunities. So that the what is the then future need for the power sectors, that it has to be made fully automatic, so that and if I break this thing, if we have a power sector, you know that we have actually basically two kinds of control we had. One, we had that local, as Arup sir said, we had local control, we had local power plant controls, and there human beings used to work there, and as per the situation that the control had been exercised, and there had been the remote control panel could be in the order of 100 meters away from the site, and at the remotely also we could manage certain controls. But due to the COVID situation that has come up to the our human society, that even we cannot we actually want that minimum manpower should be used, and more of control, more of remote control should BMOT, and I want to hear use one more word, that is not local. Of course, local control will be there. Of course, remote control will be there. One more control is stringently required for the new scenario for electrical engineers, that is telecontrol. We all know that remotely, and once I talk about this telecontrol, I mean that local control was in the order of a few hundred meters, and telecontrol, once I say telecontrol, thereby this word, I mean to say that that control should be, we should be able to control the control in the order of a few hundred kilometers, say. And if I talk about that, you might say, or someone might say, still, sir, there is a dashboard. And the dashboard can be seen from several hundred kilometers away. But if I talk about this dashboard that the power sectors that has, the dashboard cannot actually control different parameters. We can actually mainly watch different parameters. But that the requirement has come that the dashboard is not sufficient enough. We want telecontrol. I mean that, say, at least from several hundreds of kilometers away, I should be able to properly control the power sectors that we have in. So that's this telecontrol mechanism that is actually not present in the world so far that I know. But this telecontrol mechanism, that is, as remote control was fully operational in the present world, is fully operational in the present world, telecontrol is presently non-existent in the world as far as I know. There may be some exceptional cases, but in general it is not existent. So I mean that for the opportunities for electrical engineers, that stringent development for that complete automation, thereby so that from hundreds of kilometers or say thousands of kilometers away, I should be able to manage my power sectors. One more important thing that I want to say, that already the previous speaker said, and I want to add on to that if I, so far we had been knowing that power generation means it is that thermal power sector that actually gives it. So and there are many other non-conventional systems and hydropower systems that are joining so that we can actually meet the need of the power sectors. But no, nowadays new concepts are coming, that's already previous speaker told, that green energy, say the tidal power plant, the thermal power plant, solar energy. But here actually one more new concept has come into the market, and it is there with the scientists, that is micro energy generator. Because they say that if we talk about our houses, that houses we consume energy, but this our own house, we can actually instead of consumer, we can be a producer for electricity. What by what means that if we have a solar panels across our different walls, and it has been seen that a house actually using the solar panel can generate the energy that he needs, more than the energy that he needs. So surplus energy he can contribute to the grid, and thereby the consumer, that individual consumer that we consume electricity, so we can be the producer. So there the new concept is being generated, that is micro generator, that is individual houses that they call it about. So this individual house can surplus energy can contribute to the grid. And that surplus energy can be used by the others, those who cannot produce it. So in that sense, what I mean to say, this grid that we connect different power sources should be more intelligent. That is another area, that grid that we have, we need it to be the more intelligent. And another thing that I want to say, highlight for these present electrical engineers, that
I think there is a network issue.
So Kanya ma'am, you can take over.
Yes, I think there is some
there is some
technical problem. Sorry. Yes, yes. Sorry for the disturbance. Now, sorry for the interruption. Now we shall continue. A question for you, sir.
Yeah, yeah.
Why should a student opt out for electrical engineering than other streams as a career option? Arup sir, please.
Yeah.
Can you hear me?
Yes, yes, I can hear you. Please repeat the question.
Sir, I should a student opt out for electrical engineering than other streams as a
yeah right so as I told that electrical engineering itself it's a universal it's a versatile versatile means that it is not too specific to one industry it is applicable to industry across the globe as I told it started with one of the big area is the of course that electricity area whether it is a conventional electricity area non conventional electricity area when I say that electricity area it means that it is generation transmission and distribution this is the one area that's the electrical apart from that you look into across that industry that electrical engineers are required electrical engineers are required for any manufacturing plant any service industry or anything to run today to electrical engineers are there why see that everything run by machinery and whenever there is a machinery those days are gone when that machinery used to used by the IC engine that internal combustion engine diesel engine so diesel engine are no more in use anywhere even any transport anything is nowhere except that truck and other thing so all these things are electrically operated so when there is a application of electricity there is a need for engineers it is a very simple thing so it is that's why as I told earlier also even if you say that steel industry that all the machinery run by that electricity all the run by automation so all that's why that electrical engineers are required and similar kind of all industry whether it is a steel textile any kind of industry that electrical engineers are required so from job perspective if the person is interested to do this job in the core engineering area that huge prospect and as I said that if you are a good engineer a good engineer means that it means that you have to irrespective which college which country you are studying that doesn't matter but it's matter what you are studying from the electrical engineering perspective if your fundamental of electrical engineering is good then you can work across the globe anywhere as a successful electrical engineer so that's why in this electrical engineering perspective we want to build a career as a electrical engineer globe is the opportunity globe is the scope and since that everybody has to run power plant everybody run to run industry to day to day survival for the livelihood so whenever there is a industry there is a need for engineer so this is the one part second part if we look into the engineering electrical engineering study it's a little different from other engineering subject because it's lead see that electricity does not see you cannot even when I used to work in plant in power plant so that time this automation was not there and there is a big role of electrical engineers for fault finding see that mechanical and civil you can visualize if things are broken in civil you can say that this has been damaged mechanical you can say that machinery has been broken but electricity is the problem you cannot able to see anything what happened now we have to analysis based on that all your analytical skill and that's why whenever a person study engineering and engineering electrical engineering study is a very logical manner if the person not applies his analytical and logical reasoning into the in this electrical engineering he cannot be a become a good electrical engineer so this that's why that his this prospect of industry is good even in the non engineering case as I mentioned and today lot many electrical engineers joining the non engineering job and especially IT job so IT job is as I say why I say that non engineering job it is not specific to that electrical engineering what you have studied but there are application because that every 3 months or every 6 months you need to study a new technology and whenever you need to study a lot of analytical skill is required so then whatever you study during the course of studying the electrical engineering that lot of inherent skill you built up within you due to this electrical engineering study and that can help you to understand the technology very rapidly you can run very you can learn it very quickly and then that will help you in the career also so that's why I say that electrical engineering always an advantage that you can go into the engineering job as well as in the non engineering job. So that's why the electrical engineering is as compared to the IC that is the better option
thank you sir next a question to Shoaibul sir what does for engineering students
yeah
Can you please repeat? I mean, there is a lot of network issue. I mean, I cannot hear the complete sentence.
Yes, of course. So, what are the key knowledge areas that the industries are looking for electrical engineering students?
Okay. Just to give a perspective, my industry colleague Dr. Arup has already given the importance of the electrical engineering and definitely utility being the essential industry, it is going to stay. Their demand will be there. Maybe currently it might be a challenge, but yes, it is going to basically revive after some time in terms of the basically power demand and usage and all. Now, what is happening today? There is a shift of the way the operations were having. Okay. Like he also basically aptly talked about certain, utilities, a lot of tools which is coming into the IT applications are basically coming to give it as aid. Professor Sukanto also talked about like micro generation and all. So there is a way the industry is moving. There is a typical way the industry is moving. What we see, the consumers are becoming more and more proactive in terms of know how they are utilizing their utilities, how they are going to get a more quality power. Okay, so in terms of the electrical utility and all, they need to see that how they can deliver the basically the last mile, the 24/7, how they can give a quality power to their end consumer, be it industrial, consumer or residential. Okay, now there are technologies which is evolving. Okay, it has taken a shape, but definitely there is a lot more are going to come in terms of the cognitive, the process optimization. Okay, because electrical utilities are with asset intensive utilities, right? So earlier what we used to say, there is a breakdown happening, how fast we can basically take care of the maintenance of the breakdown or basically bring the situation under normal situation, right? So today there are technologies, there are a lot of analytical, let's say skills are being basically put along with getting a lot of equipment failure details. So a lot of predictive and prescriptive models are being developed and all to see that how we can minimize the failure of that. So it is not only the core business is definitely is going to stay, but the electrical engineers, they have to basically rightly adopt to various technologies, or you can call it as a IT tools, so that to basically improvise their way of operations, improvise the basically way the consumers get the benefit. So that's in a nutshell.
Thank you, sir. Now to Sopan, sir. Sir, how can one take admission electrical engineering course?
Okay, with respect to admission, this is criteria is very simple. As per Markout guidelines, they say that if a candidate has scored 45% marks in mathematics and physics, and with a combination either it is chemistry or biology, or this computer application or computer science or business studies, and overall he has passed that 10+2 examination, he is perfectly eligible for taking admission in electrical engineering under Markout scheme.
Okay, thank you, sir.
One thing I want to add
to Arup, sir.
So just to support something I want to add. So not only that, with these marks, also you have to appear in the entrance examination JEE, West Bengal JEE, or that the JEE mains of the central government. So either of they have to appear that they should have a rank, and once there is a rank, any rank that is the eligible rank, and then along with that, this is that education percentage rank. Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, please, madam.
Thank you, Arup, sir.
Yes. Are you asking, madam? Please, you are asking something. Madam, are you there?
I think she's disconnected. I'll put across the next question.
Yeah, please.
Could we design better protective infrastructure to ensure the health and safety of site workers during this pandemic situation?
See, it is a form of the electrical engineering perspective or general perspective?
The question is just basically general, but we can also associate it with electrical engineering.
See, if we look into in the electrical engineering perspective, and see, it is not related to this pandemic, this situation. See, it is a human hazard. It's a hazard. Okay, irrespective of what are the outside situation. So as far the electrical system is concerned, does it matter what situation you are? So it is, you have to save the life. So I think that I have seen this electrical engineering field, I think almost last 26, 27 years. And I know that how the things are evolving from the safety and health, the safety point of view. So you know that electricity is the biggest hazardous to the human life. See that any voltage level after 50 volt, it is sufficient to take your life. Okay. So, and those who are the person, and specifically those person is working on the electrical line, and maybe that in home or anywhere in the even housing, even electricity line. So they has to take many measures. And I think that with the due course of time, I have seen that from the electrical system perspective, what are the things has been designed, incorporated within the equipment itself, so that if the person who is operating the equipment without knowing that machine also, if the person does anything wrong, so automatically the system will take care of his life. So the things are evolving. Earlier, this kind of things were not there. Even I say that I know the days of 93, 94, that time what kind of that safety features was there for the electrical system. But with the due course of time, last 20, 25 years, I have seen many things has been incorporated, keeping that human life. Because see that if you see that rate of this thing is drastically reduced now. Even those who are the engineers, and especially the electrical engineers, used to work on the live line, like in the distribution line, transmission line, even the power generation plant. Hardly a lot of that thing was happened. What did all these things massacre happened? But now things are very, very reduced. Even most of the human touch has been reduced. No need to go to the particular equipment. Even you can, everything you can operate remotely. Lot of automation has been done. Lot of things are there. So now the things are operated. Sitting even inside the plant also, people are not there in the near to the equipment. They are at least 100 meter, 200 meter away from the equipment and operating the equipment. And since that, so that's why that all the physical safety has been taken care. Apart from that, all the system safety has been already inbuilt. So I think that's very, very advanced form it is today. But it is not directly related to the COVID, even it is related to human mankind. I think that it is a very good safety.
Right. Ma'am, Sukanya, ma'am, you can ask the next question.
Yes. Thank you, sir. Now, the next question from audience. Is there any cutoff marks for admission in joint entrance examination? That is to Shapun sir. Hello.
Hello.
Hello, Shapun sir. Can you hear me? Now, a question.
Please put up the question. Hello.
Right.
Hello. Hello. Okay, question
being asked that whether any cutoff marks for the joint entrance
admission to electrical engineering?
There is no cutoff marks. They actually, if you have the eligibility criteria and if you have the rank, as sir said, that in joint entrance or joint entrance main, you can join, but that varies from year to year. They sometimes say up to this many rank we can actually accommodate. So that is year to year that varies. But actually, in general, I should say you there is no cutoff rank that for admission. Any rank if you have, then you can join as an engineer. You can take admission for electrical engineering course or any engineering course under MACOUT.
Is another question from the audience that how do we impart technical education to our students in the current situation? That is, what are the steps taken to ensure education to the students in this lockdown?
Should I answer this question?
Yes, sir. You will answer, please.
Okay. So this we can take a lot of measures that we can deal with COVID situation perfectly. That one more that we can adopt that online education. So if there are say we can adopt Zoom, we can adopt Skype, and there are many other ways for online education. So as actually classroom activities or classroom teaching is not possible nowadays at present situation, current situation. So we can give it to this, we can go for this online education. And that is available to us at almost a very negligible cost. Okay, so this is one thing that we can go for online education. One more thing that suppose we want to give notes to the students. We can give notes to the students to the Google Classroom. There also we can give handwritten notes or even we can upload our videos. Okay, so one more thing I'll tell you, sir, if we take up these online courses, this, I particularly know that Skype has a facility that you can record the class. So someone might question that, say, sir, due to network and all, or due to the power supply was not available, I could not attend the class. So whatever class we take, we can record under Skype, we can record it, and we can then upload it to you can upload it to YouTube, then you can share it to the Google Classroom, or your college can also have a common WhatsApp group. To the common WhatsApp group also, that recorded video can be shared. So we have two facilities that directly online class can be taken through Zoom, Skype, and other things. And you can record your things so that if student cannot attend, they can see later on time that is uploaded to the Google Classroom or the common WhatsApp group. Furthermore, if you want to pass on to some your class notes, some materials for the students, then you can safely give to the common WhatsApp group that you can create it, or you can give to the Google Classroom. So this is the actually and then many other things, but at least these measures can be adopted to deal with the COVID situation with respect to imparting education to the students.
Thank you, sir. Now, considering that COVID situation is likely to stay, any message that you would like to give to the new electrical engineering students so that they become optimistic about future? Shoaibul sir, can you please tell something about this?
Yeah, thank you very much. So definitely we have to basically stay focused in whatever study we are doing today. Okay, definitely the world is not going to end. And obviously it may be a interruptions, maybe 3 months, 4 months or 6 months kind of thing, but it is going to be a normal situation, maybe in a different form. Now, what we have to look into, so we have to basically revitalize our education with various initiatives which is currently being taken. We have to stay on top of all new initiatives in the world, what is being going on. Every 6 months, what we have seen, the 4 to 6 months, the new technologies are coming, right? So earlier what we have seen that there was very minimal this audio conferencing or video conferencing tools available and all. Now there is ample, starting with Zoom, WebEx, all sorts of things are there. So there are tools are going to come. It is going to come every 6 months, 4 months and all. We have to adopt. So unless and until we adapt ourselves into the basically new normal, the new technologies, the way the world is basically going to embrace, yes, we have to basically keep our eyes and ears open and try and adopting all these new technologies and all. And like what Arup said that, okay, it's not the normal process industry anymore kind of thing, right? So we have to basically look into a lot of cognitive analyticals, viewpoints and all, be it running the process quite efficiently, operations quite efficiently with the help of tools, so that whether we are at the control center, we are at the remote locations, the tools are going to reinvent and all, right? So we will be definitely able to use all these technologies and all. So we have to stay geared up and see how do we impress all these new technologies. The college has to basically adapt all these technologies quite quickly and impart all these facilities to the students. And students also need to basically keep on reinventing this new ways of basically teaching, new ways of working, and embrace the industry. Thank you from my anything.
Arup sir, do you want to add anything to it?
Yeah. So yes.
Thank you, sir. Arup sir, yes, do you want to add anything more to it?
Yes. Yes. Yes, madam, sir. Thank you. So, Mr. Sahiwal, as I add to what Mr. Sahiwal was saying, as I say that life and livelihood both said to be run, and it is not for the everybody. And those who are the engineers, that new engineers, those who are the old engineers like us, so we know that that what are the things to be done and what are the thing how we can have to manage the thing. But those who are the new engineers, new electrical engineers, they have lot of ambiguity what will be happened. So as I mentioned that in addition to the electrical engineering aspect, they need to understand new more technology to enrich them so that they can show more values to the society. As I told that all the job cannot be now all that on-site job. You have to manage many job from offshore. So you have to equip yourself like such that you can able to work from offshore and people will recognize it. See, those who are the employer, you can able to show that, yes, I'm talking about the electrical engineering perspective. But to enrich the electrical engineering, as Sapun sir was saying, that today that what are the grid systems running, so grid systems should be smart. Smart in the meaning there should be inbuilt intelligence. That today we are always thinking that how to improve the efficiency, how to improve the reliability of the power supply. We are expecting there should be zero breakdown across the industry of power system. So then you have to build the intelligence onto the system so that any kind of problem comes, that the system itself can able to sense that problem and can take the corrective measures. So to do that, you have to build that analytics and analogy into the system. So those things has to work, that electrical engineers has to, those who are the basically fresher electrical engineer, they have a fresher in mind. So based on their one knowledge, that core electrical knowledge, on top of that, they have to include those technology also into that to take it forward. And this will be exciting also. It is not that conventional electrical engineering may be a little boring, but this type of innovative technology, innovative solution, one will be good for the society, good for the industry. At the same time, those who are the engineers, they will also enjoy the job. So that's the point I want to highlight.
Thank you, sir. Now we have another question from an audience, that is solar power transmission part of electrical engineering? Shoaibal sir, if you can say something about it.
Yeah, today the solar is definitely one of the basically key area in terms of the renewable energy, right? So whether it's a industrial, solar is being used in an industrial usage, let's say basically setting up power for powering the entire airport or various industrial purpose. So it is being used also in residential solar usage very extensively, starting with a very high-rise buildings, in the community buildings. So solar generation is definitely and over the years gradually the cost of the solar equipments also has come down drastically. So more and more the basically cost has come down, and consumer also basically has taken the initiative, and there are government initiatives also which are basically helped to embrace this technology in a better way. So definitely, however, I would like Professor Shapun Majumdar and Dr. Arup Sinha to see that how exactly this subject can be basically included at the core electrical, or it can be a additional subject and all. I will not be able to comment on that much.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, sir. Arup Sinha, sir.
Yeah, I can add. Yeah, thank you, Sahiwal. See, if you look into, as I earlier mentioned, there are different sources of supply, that thermal source that are based on the coal, gas, then other nuclear source, and then hydel source. So these are the sources are conventional source. It was happening since beginning. But now that across the world, that renewable power is coming very, very heavily. And many countries in the developed country like Germany, they are in the pace of 70% to 80% in the renewable power. Renewable power, whenever I say, that mainly based on the solar and wind energy. So solar transmission, it's like that there are two kind of grid system there. The one is the conventional grid and one is that your renewable grid. Now, how the renewable grid works, that conventional grid like a main streamline, and whatever the renewable line, they are like a, you can say that it is just like a branch, okay? So they used to supply, that solar power used to supply that local area. What are the local area is mentioned to that. And in addition to that, what are the surplus power after meeting the demand of that particular area, that's transmitted to the conventional power. So there is a grid, that is the conventional grid, and that conventional grid is connected to the conventional power supply, like thermal, like gas, like nuclear. But those of the solar system is there, whatever the surplus power, they are fitting that surplus power into that conventional grid after meeting the target of the local thing. That's the one kind of business model. Other business model is there, that solar power is dedicatedly connected to the conventional power to distribute the power to other customers, those who are in the remote. So if I say that my solar power is somewhere in Uttarakhand, and I have a contract with that solar power in Kolkata, what happened? Those who are the power generator, they will generate the electricity, and then they will step up that power, that allows that what are the voltage in that solar power, there is a low voltage, and they step up into the high voltage, then there will be a transmission line will come in between that solar power and to the conventional power, and that will be fit to the conventional power to give the supply to that end consumer. So these are the things that are being happening. And there are two kind of model, one exclusively through the transmission line, and other is from the meeting the local demand. After meeting the local demand, what are the surplus power that is feeding into the commercial.
Thank you, sir. Now, one more question from the audience to Shopun, sir. For admissions to engineering, only physics, chemistry, and mathematics marks of plus two level are taken into account. But if someone takes computer science as a subject at the plus two level, then will the marks of computer science be also considered for admissions to BTech courses?
Okay, answer I have already given, but I'm giving with a clarity that if you want to take an admission in engineering, that is, you must have physics and you must have mathematics and physics. And on an average, you have to score 45 marks in mathematics and physics. If you have mathematics and physics, and if you have 45% marks, then addition other third subject, you can have either it is chemistry, or it can be biology, or it can be computer science, or it can be computer application, or it can be business studies. This is the basic criteria. And you should have that is rank in the West Bengal joint or JEE main. That is the criteria for taking admission in engineering under mark out scheme. Is it clear?
Yes, thank you, sir. Now, I would like to thank the presenters for sharing their valuable informations, which I'm sure benefited the audience greatly. Thank you for participating in the webinar. We hope you all had a fruitful and engaging time. Thank you all.
Okay. Thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. And thank you, everybody. And thank you, audience.